Learning about seven different concepts. The first one is translation, then we'll move on to vertical reflection, horizontal reflection. Number four is vertical and horizontal reflection combined. Number five is glide reflection. And number six, vertical reflection and glide reflection. Number seven is a half turn. You can find symmetry everywhere. Schilling Hall is an example of vertical symmetry, which means that you take the vertical axis mirror image of the pattern, then repeat the pairs.
Does Schilling have any other types of symmetry?
The clock on Schilling is an example of vertical and horizontal symmetry because it can be equally divided vertically and horizontally. These bricks are a great example of a translation, which means that the pattern repeats itself over and 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 over again.
Oh my gosh, Genevieve, is that horizontal symmetry?
For sure.
Just so it's like more clear.
Yes, it does! The grill work on Gorin Hall is an excellent example of both horizontal and vertical symmetry because it can be divided equally on both the vertical and horizontal axis. Pattern is an example of a glide reflection, which means that you copy the pattern and reflect it along the horizontal axis. It's somewhat difficult to find this rare species of vertical reflection and glide reflection combined in nature, so we're going to create one for you. First, I'm going to translate myself by creating the vertical axis mirror image, and then create the glide reflection by copying the pattern and reflecting it along the horizontal axis.
Are they an example of symmetry?
These cloud-watching students are a great example of a half-turn, which means that you translate the pattern and then rotate it 180 degrees.
Infinity times, I am one with the symmetry!
Infinity times, infinity times, infinity times, infinity. Let there be light, let there be light, let me be right. The dust of dies, you're the apple of God's eye. We are yeah.